Well, nearly 2 weeks after Chad was added to an amended U.S. travel ban list, questions continue about why the African country was included. Viewer's Mariama Diallo looks at the implications for Chad.
Given its scope of counterterrorism work with its regional and international partners, Chad being added to a U.S. travel ban list continue to raise questions. Raymond Gilpin is the dean of the Africa Center for Strategic Studies at the National Defense University in Washington.
Chad has had a leadership role in the multinational joint task force for the Lake Chad Basin area, has 700 troops. Chad has also participated in a number of European and American-led counterterrorism exercises. 2016, just last year, Chad had the presidency of the G5 Sahel.
It appears, at least on the surface, Gilpin says, that Chad has been a willing and able U.S. partner.
It's difficult to see what Chad did not do and Sudan did do that saw them one country off the list and the other country on the list. So this has been perplexing, not just in Chad, but across the continent, because people are asking questions about the extent to which partnership and international initiatives could work in your favor when it comes to something as important and as crucial as the travel ban to the United States.
A country being on a travel ban list can send negative signals to investors who, in general, are spooked by insecurity, experts say. Brian McCullough is the co-chairman of the U.S. Chad Investment Council. He came back from Chad 3 days before the travel ban was issued and says the feeling in Chad is that a friend just betrayed you. But while it's understandable, he says the focus should be somewhere else.
The overall commercial and diplomatic relationship is strong, and it's still predicated on the cooperation that the United States and Chad have had over the past decades. I was just at State Department, and they're looking forward to working with Chad on getting whatever it is that they need to do to lift the ban as quickly as possible. But then, of course, they're still maintaining their portfolio of security, humanitarian, and business relationships that they already have, and looking to strengthen those.
He also attended the launch of Chad's new 2017-2021 National Development Plan last month in Paris.
They're looking to seriously increase a lot of economic activity, the business climate, improve really the environment for the private sector.
How is that all going to play out after this ban, many are asking. The language issued by the White House says Chad is an important and valuable counterterrorism partner, but it also adds that Chad does not adequately share public safety and terrorism-related information. For that reason, the entry into the U.S. of nationals of Chad on B-1 and B-2 visas is hereby suspended. Mariama Diallo, VOA News, Washington.